Hey guys, I hope y'all are doing good. So welcome to Aki Vlogs. My name is Saransh Singh and I'm an architect by profession. I keep making such videos on a regular basis, and if you want, you can go out and check out my other playlist also. And in this video, I'm gonna show you how to get 3D contour or 3D site data on Sketchup. I have been using this website for a very long time, and if you want, you can even get the geolocation data and even the 3D data on Sketchup itself. You don't have to use any website or anything else. So all these things I'll be covering up in this video. So try watching this video till the end. And guys, if you are here on my channel for the first time, go ahead and hit a like and subscribe to my channel. And without any delays, let's get started with the video. So guys, let's get started with our first site, that is our CADMapper. CADMapper is really, really amazing site. I have been using this site for, I think so, more than 2-3 years. And this is how the interface of this website looks. Once you open this website, you need to sign in by your Google account or any account that is there, any email ID you can put it in. And this is how the interface looks. Here you can see like what kind of data you want. Like if you want it for AutoCAD, you can select that. You can select SketchUp, Rhino, ArchiCAD. So yeah, mostly all the formats you will get over here. You can even export this data in SketchUp and then get it converted into some other file formats. That I have been doing this for a very long time, like for Revit and shit, I have been doing this. So yeah, it's fairly simple and it's very nice to use. So here you can see, you can include your topography contours at every 4 meters. So what this symbolizes is like, okay, you will have contour levels given at every 4 meters, and this ratings and this 4 meters, 10 meters, 5 meters thing will change based on the location and based on the like if you are located in city, the accuracy of the model or the 3D data will be very nice and very accurate, and the topography will be also very in a very fine geometry. Let's go ahead and see a site. So this was one of our site that was given to us. So I'll just select it, and you can see at the bottom over here, like it's written as free file. So if you go above 1 kilometer, this will charge you money. So see, I am at one kilometer, like 1.49 kilometers square kilometers. So this is charging me $6. So try being in a small area as much as possible. Anyways, let's go ahead. Let's select this region, and you just have to go ahead and click create file. It will show you like estimated time and things. You will get a preview of this is your 3D data, 2D data, topography. So this will be your contour lines. And then you can go ahead, and this is an AutoCAD format because I selected AutoCAD. So you can download this. So it is downloading. And if you want, you can again go back, select SketchUp 15 and create a file. So guys, this is how the file looks for CADMapper. Like when you will download, it will be a zip file. Once you extract it, this will be the file, and here you will have your SketchUp file or AutoCAD file or Rhino file, whatever file you have selected to download. I have selected the SketchUp one, so I will just open and I will just show you how the data looks like. So you can see over here, like it has generated pretty accurate site configuration because I have the contour for this site specifically. So it has given you the basic heights of the building or whatever building was located. And actually this site is in dense forest, so that's why the data won't be highly accurate. But you can do the similar thing for any place around the world or any city around the world. So this is one part, and if you want, you can do something similar in SketchUp itself. So you go in the file, then you will go in this geolocation, add location, and from here, like I did this for the current location. This is the Parliament Hill region of Ottawa, so I know this area pretty well, and I know like how the terrain is over here, so I won't do much. I will select the region. You have to select the image provider. Just go for digital globe. High res near map would be expensive, so just go on this. And from here you can even select the region or the range of what you want in your site. So let's select this and click on import. So here it is. And guys, the best part is like it will be true to the north. So like if you have like you have to decide the actual north of the site, this image has come according to the north. So like if north is up over here, so this is based on that. So this is how it locates itself and orients itself. So it's a very useful tool. And this is one part. If you want to see the terrain of the region, just click on file, go on the geolocation again and click on show terrain. So see, here you can see the terrain. And this file is 2D scale. It won't be of random size. So that is also a very interesting thing to look for. And for buildings, now what to do for buildings. So you can go ahead and go to your components. And once you go in your components, you will see next to the house, you will see this drop down menu. And over here, you just have to click nearby models. Once you click this, it will start searching the nearby models. And if you don't know the building name, you can go on Google Earth and search for the building names, or and just come here and like, you know, click for the building. Okay, fine. I will select one of the building. So this is one of the structure that I know. So what it will do is it will directly load this structure onto your map. So this is actually exactly where this building is located, and they have the imagery and everything set up on this building itself. So it's a pretty cool tool to use, and there are many more things to cover, but I won't be covering those in this video. I hope this helped you. And CADMapper is my go-to site. I use it on almost every project just to see what the terrain is like, what are the sections on the terrain is like. So a lot you can do with that, and even you can get the contour lines on DWG. So like you can import that on Revit later and create a terrain of yourself and even modify those terrains. So there's a lot to see and lot to learn. You can go ahead, check it out. The link is in the description of these both the sites, and like a link of a YouTube video that explains, like it's a YouTube video by Sketchup itself. It will explain you everything in detail. So go ahead, check it out. And guys, if this video was helpful for you all, go ahead, hit a like and subscribe to my channel. And I'll see you soon. Bye-bye.